G'day everybody. G'day, Con Chloe. How are you today?
Same.
Good day, teacher. How are you?
How are you, teacher?
G'day. G'day everybody. G'day, Emilio. G'day, Rayland. How are you today?
Have a good day, ma'am.
Good. And for you, g'day, Kongla. G'day.
Good day, miss.
Good day.
And Steffi, hey, are you there?
Oh, yeah, I'm here. Sorry.
Good day, Steffi.
How are you?
Yeah, I'm good. Is your camera working? Yeah, good. Thank you. Nice to see you.
Thank you.
Hey, guys, we had a good class yesterday, I think. Do you agree? Is there any feedback from yesterday? Any questions? No? Or quiet?
No.
Good. Quiet on the Western Front. All right, let's get our work done. When I find it. Alvin, g'day.
Hi, g'day, teacher. G'day, everyone.
G'day, Dizzy, you made it.
Yeah,
I'm here. Hello, teacher. Finally, yesterday I tried a lot. I called Connect.
I know, I saw.
It's so good to see you again.
Yes, good to see you.
Because I can see you.
Good to see you too. Is your camera working today, Dizzy?
Yeah, teacher, sorry.
Cool, thank you. All right, so everybody, can you open your Moodle, please? So we are in Red 5, remember? Can you check, Dizzy, that you have Red 5 in your Moodle, please?
Yes, I think Red 4.
You should have Red 5 now.
Can we do the Red 5, teacher?
Yeah, oh, you weren't here yesterday either. Yep, so check your Moodle.
Yep, Red 5.
You got Red 5, yep?
Yep.
No, teacher, I don't have it. Only Red 5, Red 4, sorry, 1 and 2.
Okay.
And ESA Bar 6.
Okay, all right. I will help you with that. Okay, so while you're waiting, everybody, you can have a look at week 1, speaking part 2. Remember, know your numbers. And if you can open the Word document I sent you as well, if you did not have a chance to read it last night. Okay, so Dizzy, we've got, so this is for our new intake. So this intake, we're using Red 5. We have new materials there. Let me just add you. Which email are you using, Dizzy?
I'm sending my email now.
Oh, that's right. Can you see my screen?
Yes, I can see it, but I can't see my email there. Just a second.
Okay.
No, it's not there.
Teacher, I couldn't read the document today because I had a crazy day.
That's okay. Why don't you have a look at it now while you're waiting for me and Dizzy?
Okay, great.
So we, teacher, what we gonna do now? So we gonna treat.
Yeah, I sent my email to you.
Okay, thanks. What was that, Chloe?
Yes, so I'm gonna go into the Red 5 and speaking lesson part 2.
Yep, so I want you to go to week Red 5.
Yeah, week 1.
Week 1.
And
speaking.
Speaking.
Just go to the speaking.
Yep.
I can see the speaking lesson part 2 video.
Yep, that's it.
That you want we to read it.
I just want you to look at it while we're waiting to fix Dizzy's Moodle.
Yep.
Okay, Dizzy, do you have this one now?
Let me check again, teacher. Not yet, teacher. I don't have it.
Can you refresh?
Let me try again. Because I'm using my phone, it's hard sometimes. No, I still didn't have it.
All right, okay, we'll worry about it afterwards, Dizzy.
Okay.
I'll make sure that your email's correct. Okay. All right, so let's go here. Dizzy, you just look at the screen. So Chloe and Dizzy, this is a new intake. So we're back to week 1, okay? So we're looking here, speaking, and we've got the video. I'm going to play that again for you guys because we didn't watch it properly yesterday.
G'day everybody and welcome to Turner English TV. It is so nice to see you again today. And today's lesson is all about IELTS speaking and in particular the part 2 speaking section of the IELTS exam.
One second guys, you need to be making notes, okay?
So, but before we begin, if you haven't already subscribed to Turner English TV, please make sure you click on the bell below so that you can receive notifications so that we can come to you. You don't always have to come to find us. But let's get started. So most of you, I assume, have done the IELTS test before, and part two can be very stressful because you have to talk for 2 minutes without stopping. You have to generate ideas. You have to think about your grammar. So there's a lot of things to think about, and it can be quite stressful. And if you don't have a really good start to part two, it can really put you off for the rest of the exam. And of course, the examiner is going to mark you down and you'll have a bad first impression, which is not going to work in your favor. But before we look at how we're going to begin part two, let's look at what the examiner is looking for. Examiners are marking in four criteria, and that criteria is task response. Am I answering the question? Coherency and cohesion, am I linking my ideas and sentences? Vocabulary, which is lexical resource, and of course the last one here is grammar. And this one that we focus on today kind of covers all of the above. And so it's a really powerful punch and a really strong start to any topic that you might have in part two. So you won't get shocked or stumped or go silent in the test, because the minute you go silent, your scores are going to go down. So some common topics that we have in part two are things like books, songs, films, people you admire, places you've been to, tourist attractions that you've enjoyed, holidays that you've been on. So they're all pretty topical and they all come round often. So if you practice this one structure and get this mastered by the end of the video, you can attack any topic for part two with the same method, and you will be feeling very good about the exam. But also, I guarantee it's going to move your score up, especially if you're sitting on the 6.5 and you need the 7, or the 5.5 and need the 6, then this is really going to give you that boost that you need. The way it works is this. We have an opening statement, which we're going to use no matter what the topic is, and it goes like this. There are a lot of books I can talk about. Or if it's songs, there are a lot of songs I can talk about. Or if it's movies, films, there are a lot of films I can talk about. And then I'm going to say, but today I'll talk about Rosa Parks, which is a book that I'm reading at the moment. Or, but today I'll talk about Reverend, which is a film I saw on Saturday. So as you can see, I can use the same sentence to start off, that any topic you're given in part two will help. Now, why is this such a great topic? Let's have a look at it from what an examiner is looking at. So with an examiner, they're looking at, as we mentioned, grammar. But grammar has two parts. So it has accuracy and range. So your grammar has to be correct, and then you also have to have a range of sentence structures. There are four types of sentences in English: simple, compound, complex, compound complex. I'll say that again. Simple, compound, which is two sentences joined together with and, but, so, or because. Complex, and compound complex. So if we have a look at this sentence here, there are a lot of songs I can talk about, but today I'll talk about Lift Me Up. That's a song that I like. And if I look at that, what type of sentence is this sentence? I have but, so it is a compound sentence. Two simple sentences connected together with and, so, but, or because. So you can connect those two sentences together with but. So it's a nice compound sentence. It's 100% correct, and it's answering exactly what the examiner is asking me to do. There are a lot of books I can talk about, but today I'll talk about Rosa Parks. Now let's take it up a notch. Let's make it a little bit higher, and we're going to add more complexity. Let's say why there's a lot of books I can talk about. There are a lot of books I can talk about because I love reading. But today I'll talk about Rosa Parks. Now what have I done? Now I have a compound sentence, 100% correct, grammatical range, on topic, a really good first impression for your part two. Let's try it again with a song. There are a lot of songs I can talk about because I love singing. But today I'll talk about Lift Me Up. Let's try the last one. The last one is films. There are a lot of films I can talk about because I love going to the movies with my friends. But today I'll talk about Reverend. So you can see I'm not doing anything that difficult. I'm just practicing and remembering that first opening statement to give a good, strong first impression for part two. And I'm getting my grammar range up. I'm also connecting my ideas nicely. So connecting ideas and sentences is our CC. So this is also going up. The other thing I'm doing well is task response. I'm exactly on topic. I'm not waffling. I'm not talking about something different. I am right on topic. So these are all very strong straight away. Let's go a bit higher. Let's try because when I was... I loved reading. Now we've got some nice flow. So there are a lot of books I can talk about because when I was at high school, I loved reading. But today I'll talk about Rosa Parks, which is a book I'm reading at the moment, if you want to put a little comment on the end. The next one, songs. There are a lot of songs I can talk about because when I have free time, I love to listen to music. But today I'll talk about Lift Me Up. The last one, there are a lot of films I can talk about because when I get home from work and I'm tired, I love to watch movies. But today I'll talk about Reverend. So now you can see we have a really strong opening statement, which is going to give a good impression in the examiner's mind straight away from the word go. So if you open with something like that, they're going to be thinking seven at least. And then your job for the rest of the part of part two is to add vocabulary, ideas and extension, which we have some other videos explaining how to do that. But the opening is really the first impression. I hope that video is helpful and I would love for you to give me some feedback. Perhaps you've tried in your exam and it's worked for you. And then let the others know down below in the comments box. But thank you very much for watching our video and have a great day.
Okay, any questions? No questions.
Mr. Lin?
Yes, Mike?
Before we do the test for part two, we can write down first before we speak for 2 minutes.
Correct. So you have 1 minute to prepare. Do you remember we spoke yesterday about the Windows strategy? You remember this mode?
Yes. Yes, I remember.
So if you remember to make a box on your paper, you can start making notes under these sections. So remember you only have 1 minute. So you told me, I think, that it was important to communicate with your family because they are far away. So we made that shorter, communicate with distant family. Does that make sense, Mode?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, so this is called window strategy, and all you do is make a box on your paper like this. So it's easier to remember points rather than full sentences. Okay, so let's talk about test. Okay, so in this document, which I sent you, Mode, this is what the IELTS test will look like. This is part two. Remember, know your numbers, part two. So this is how long it will take. Okay, Mode, can you read this one?
Test focus. This part of the test focuses on the ability to speak at length on a given topic without further prompts from the examiner. Using appropriate language and organizing ideas coherently is likely that the test takers will need to draw on their own experience to complete the long term.
Okay, good. So is there any words you did not understand, Mode?
Coherently.
Coherently?
Yeah, and the prompt.
Okay, so coherently means clear and understandable. So the examiner needs to understand. So when it says organizing ideas coherently, this is why we teach you to use the window strategy, because this is a clear way to organize your thoughts. And prompt is, so in this situation, you will be given a card. I'll call that a cue card. And the cue card will have something like this. So describe your favorite gadget. You should say these things in your answer. So these are prompts. The examiner will not give you any more prompts. If you are, okay, so if you're doing a road race on your bike, maybe part of the competition is doing your own navigation, but you only have that map. You have no more clues, ideas, hints. They can also be prompts. Does that help? Does that help, Mo? Oh, you're on mute.
I understand, teacher.
You do understand? Yes?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So I just gave you a prompt then when I said, you do understand? I'm prompting you to give me more information. Okay. It's so next one. Yes. Yeah, sorry.
The meaning is to say, it's a nobody to give you a tips or mention something for you. So is the meaning is like that?
Can you repeat, Alvin?
I mean, it's the without further prompt for the examiner. The meaning is say, you just think about yourself or nobody to mention you and give you some idea or something like that. Is correct?
Yep. So let's put what you said into a better sentence.
Oh.
Is the meaning of prompts?
I understand. Thank you.
That the examiner cannot give you any more ideas. You have to think for yourself.
Yeah, everyone come from yourself idea, right?
Yep. So the ideas, this is why they want to know, what is a piece of technology that I can't live without? Me. Nobody else. Me.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so you have these prompts. What does it look like? How do I use it? Why is it vital? Etc. So no more prompts, no more. The ideas all have to now come from you.
Yep, yep. Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay, task instructions. Rayland.
Yes.
Can you read this one here, please?
The examiner gives the test takers a task card that asks the test takers to talk about a particular topic, includes points to cover in their talk, and instructs the test takers to explain one aspect of the topic.
Okay, good. So anything there you don't understand, Rayland?
I understand, teacher.
Okay, good. Thank you. So this is the card?
Yep.
That we're talking about mode? And it will look something like this. Okay, what's our next instruction, Faru?
The test takers are given 1 minute to prepare their talk and are given a pencil and paper to make notes.
Very good. Thank you, Faru. Nice reading. So this piece of paper is the paper that the examiner has given you with a pencil. And so the best way to be, or the most effective way, best, is to make your notes like this. So take the prompts and put them in each box, and you have 1 minute. Okay, the next one, please, Chloe Lai.
The examiner asks the test takers to talk for 1 to 2 minutes, stop the test takers after 2 minutes, and ask one or two questions on the same topic.
Okay. So as we can see, it goes for 3 to 4 minutes. So 1 minute for preparation, 2 minutes for talking, and then the examiner will stop you after 2 minutes. So they'll have a timer, and then they will ask you one or two more questions. Okay, so who's next, please? Dizzy.
Yes, teacher. Task effectiveness. Using the points of the task cards effectively, the making and making notes during the preparation time will help the test takers think of appropriate things to say, structure their talk, and keep talking for 2 minutes.
Okay, so this word here is appropriate.
Appropriate, yeah.
Yeah, appropriate. Do you understand what that means, Dizzy?
Yeah, yeah. I have done the IELTS test, teacher, in 2021. Yeah.
I know.
No, it's not so difficult, though. Look, just you have to prepare before you go.
Yeah, exactly. You have to be prepared, like, right?
If you prepared before you go, everything will be okay.
Yeah, that's right. So you take all these sorts of notes and information that we give you, and you should be fine. So effectiveness relates to this. Okay, so you might talk for 2 minutes about technology you can't live without, but you may not mention these. And that is a mistake, because they're already giving you guides on the card. Okay, so that's what the IELTS speaking part two, remember your numbers, looks like. So it's only 3 to 4 minutes, but you know, you got to prepare, like Dizzy said. Okay, so we're going to try this today. So I'm going to give you 5 minutes to write down an answer. So you can make your own choice. So you need to answer this one or this one or this one or this one. So that this is just practice. This is just warm up. Okay, so I want you to write for 5 minutes and then you will speak in class. You will read from your writing. Okay, does everybody understand?
But so what topic we have to speak, teacher?
You can choose. You can choose from... Let me make it a bit easier. We'll do numbers. Know your numbers. You can choose from 1, 2, 3, or 4.
Yeah.
Khan, Chloe? So your choice. All right. So everybody pick a topic. I'll give you 5 minutes and then we'll come back. And just a hint, we want you to use the information from the video you just watched. We want you to try it that way. Okay, 5 minutes. got a minute and 20 seconds. Okay, time's up, guys. Okay, Farooq, can you go first, please? No, Farooq's frozen. She is very frozen. Steffi, can you go first, please?
Yeah.
Okay. So just read what you wrote down, Steffi.
Okay. I choose the topic about talk about some technology that you have to start using very recently. I start using a new laptop. It is a brand called HP, made from America, and is silver color, appearance like Apple MacBook, but nothing as Apple MacBook. My laptop is bigger than Apple MacBook. I started to using it because I need to start online course. And my laptop is quite easy to use. Its operating system is Microsoft Windows, which I use it this season since I was in high school. I used to Microsoft Windows system. It made me to do online course easier because I know how to set up accounts or where I can download Zoom, how can I connect handphone and microphone. Also, I use a lot of Microsoft apps, for example, Word, Excel, PowerPoint. I write the essays by Word. I use Excel to calculate my budget, and I use the PowerPoint to create the slide page for my workplace. Sometimes we need to explain some new dishes, and then I just make use PowerPoint to explain to my coworker what is the new menu. Yes, that's my topic. Thank you for listening.
Sorry, that was pretty good, Steffi. There was a lot of information in there. My other computer just dropped out. So I heard the beginning and the end. But I think at the beginning, you might want to think about what the video told you. So we need to make those compound sentences. Yep. So you had a lot of good information and you're clear, but yeah, let's try to work on the sentences, okay, at the beginning to introduce what you're talking about.
Okay.
All right. Let me just try to get my other screen back up so I can continue sharing. Okay, Zoom's having a little problem now, aren't they? All right, so while we're waiting for me to do this, Let's go to mode now. Can you please read yours for everybody, mode?
Yes. All right, just question number 4. Describe your favorite gadget. There are a lot of smartwatch I can talk about because when I did sport activities, I love to use Apple smartwatch. But today, I love to use smartwatch, but today I will talk about Apple smartwatch. This is Apple smartwatch. It's a blue color. Is using the tempered glass cover. I use it for my sport activity such as cycling, running, and swimming. It's vital for me because I can check heart rate, the wind, the map for the direction where I want to go, and also it can check my blood oxygen. How do other people live without it? They can just normally use their manual. I don't know how to speak about that. That's all for me.
It's too hard to speak about.
The last point.
That's okay. Just say something real quick now. You're nearly there. I can hear you. You're nearly there.
How do other people live without it?
Mm-hmm.
They can use the manual time for calculate their performance. I don't know.
okay. So are you trying to say they can calculate the time, their times in their head? Okay, so yeah, that was good. I could see the idea was there, but you just needed to make it a bit clearer. That's all. So that word you wanted to know, coherent. So coherent, the word from earlier. So I took your sentence and made it coherent. I made it easier to understand in English. Yep. Okay, but that was good. So nice introduction, and we can, what's wrong? Something's happening to my internet, guys. We can just work on the other issues in the next step. All right, so Dizzy, can you please read yours?
Yes, teacher. I just saying it. I didn't write because if I write it, I'm going to say something else. Today, there are lots of things I want to talk about, but today I want to talk about Messenger. A Messenger is very easy app to use, and I use it with this app to talk with my family who lived in Greece. And there are several reasons why I like this app. Firstly, because I can communicate with my family, friends, and I can share moments with them or important moments when I'm not with them. Secondly, it's very easy to use. It's free. Lots of people don't have to pay money to talk with their loved one. And lastly, this app make me very happy and good because I can talk with loved one. Yeah.
Oh, sorry, I didn't hear that last bit. I thought you finished. Makes me happy and good.
Yeah, it makes me feel good. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so yeah, that was really good, Dizzy. So you understand. No, that's all right. You did well. It made a lot of sense. You explained really why. Oh, hang on. Everyone can see my bedroom. There we go. So you explained why you could use Messenger for you, which was the important thing. Why does it work for you? And I also liked how you used the firstly, secondly, and lastly. That was good because that means you were following the way that we want you to speak in the IELTS test. Thanks, Dizzy. All right, Chloe, Lai, you're next.
Okay. There are lots of technology gadgets I can talk about, but because I'm a gadget freak, I love how convenient they brought, especially they save valuable time of mine. So today I will talk about Dyson vacuum I just bought 6 months ago. And it has a long purple stick and easy to use for everyone. And if you I charge it to full, I can use it for like almost 40 minutes. The suction function is really strong comparing to my old vacuum, which I bought at Kmart. I always use it to clean my mattress, sofa, and the floor. And because I have psoriasis, which caused my skin fill off lots of dander. And because I got a cat in Taiwan before, so I always clean it's like fur on the sofa, also on my bed. Yeah. Okay. If people live without it, they can use a broom to sweep the floor or the like duster. Before they were there's no vacuum here. People use broom and duster to clean the floor and dust everything. I can't live without my Dyson but people who didn't understand how much time they and effort they can save, they just don't care.
Yeah.
And it's also expensive to afford it.
Okay, good. That was really good, Chloe. That was excellent. I liked your piece of technology. I like Dyson vacuum cleaners very much. Yeah. Just one thing to correct you there. When you were talking about the broom, in English we would say a dustpan. So you know the little pan you sweep into?
Uh-huh.
We call that a dustpan.
Oh, how about the, like,
Oh, you meant to, like, clean your shelf?
Yeah.
Okay, so, yeah, that's a duster. Sorry, I thought you meant the dust because we would say dustpan and broom when we're talking about sweeping the floor.
Yeah,
but you also mean dust for, so maybe you could say for dusting, like the action of dusting. Because a vacuum, a Dyson, is vacuuming the floor. That's what we think about.
Okay. Thank you.
All right. No worries. Thanks. And let's go to Bayou, please.
Yep. Nice. Today I'm talking about what gadget you like. Actually I like laptop because the use of laptops as learning media provide benefits for accelerating assignment completion, excelling course lead structuring information and finding sorts of learning material that can be accepted at any time, and laptop media can improve student learning achievement. But the problem for now, I haven't got a laptop because I haven't got money to buy the laptop, but maybe in next or when, if I have money, I'm gonna buy the laptop. But the laptop is really important for me, I think, and make easy to study. Yeah.
Okay, good. All right, that was good. So for you, I think you need to watch the video again, because we want you to use this structure.
Structure.
Yeah, so there is a lot of technology I can talk about, but today I'll talk about laptops. Okay, so we would like you to talk something like that. It was very clear. I understood everything, so that was good. When you were talking about how expensive they are, you could have said, I don't have a laptop at the moment. At the moment, they are very expensive.
Yep.
And I just can't afford one.
Yep.
But I am saving money to buy it because I feel a laptop is very important for my study. It's a long sentence. Yeah, because that was the part that I felt that you were a little bit unsure of, right?
Yeah.
So when we say things when they're very, like, a lot of money, we say they're expensive.
Yep.
And you can't, I can't afford it. So I want to go to Bali, as you know. But it's expensive to fly and stay in hotels, and I just can't afford it. That's how I would speak.
Yes. All good. Yeah, no, I'm understanding this.
Cool. Good.
Try again.
Sorry, say that again, Bayou.
I'll try again.
Yeah, that's okay. You did really well. It was clear, though. It was clear for me, which was good. All right, let's go to Rayland.
For me, there's a lot of gadget. I can talk about gadget because my favorite gadget is my Android phone for now, because it's easy to use and accessible to use people all age. And it's very easy to update the phone and download the apps. And it's very easy to connect the smart TV to, if you want to to watching a movies from your phone. It's very cheap for me than the Apple phone. I think that's it.
Okay, good. All right, that's good. That was very clear. That was good. And you tried to use this?
Yes.
Okay, so that was really good. You did say the word easy a lot.
Okay, Mom.
So let's think of some words that mean the same thing. So right now I can think of simple.
Okay.
So your main point was it has a lot of features which are easy. So you can say it's easy.
Okay.
Easy to use for any ages. It is simple to download the apps, etc. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, Mom.
You're welcome. All right. Who's left? Emilio.
Yes, I'm here, teacher.
Ready?
Yeah. So I would like to talk about the second sentence about some technology that I have started using recently. So I know that there are a lot of technology that I can talk about, but I will talk about computers because I started using the computer again after many years since I was a child. When I started with my English classes. So I knew that it would be a very useful tool to be able to see and listen better to my classes. And also I can do my homework more comfortable. And finally, that I can download all the documents. That's it.
That's it. Okay, good. That was good. So yeah, that was pretty clear. You told me you used the introduction technique. Okay, so you said there are a lot. So maybe you could have put a bit more in this sentence. So there is lots of technology I can talk about because I have always loved using technology. Or there are not a lot of technology that I can talk about because I don't use technology much. So we can say anything in between these spaces, but we just want to try to start with this structure.
Okay.
Okay, so that was fine. You did it fine, but you just could have put a little bit more in the middle. And what was the other thing? So you stumbled over the word comfortable.
Comfortable, yeah.
In that way, I probably wouldn't say, I'd go back to the word probably easy or simple if I was talking about using technology for my homework, for my study. I probably just wouldn't say comfortable. You could say something like, it makes my study time feel more comfortable. That would be okay, but even so, it makes study time easier.
Yeah, but also if I'm talking about the homework, yeah, I can use simple or...
Yeah, simple, easy, convenient.
Yeah.
So convenient, definitely. You know, you have the internet, you can get materials like Bayou was saying, you can get materials very quickly. Comfortable, it just seems a little bit out of place. That's fine though. That was really good. Thank you, Emilio. And you. Chloe, the other one. when you don't have your name on the screen and I see Zoom user, I stumble. I've always stumbled. Come, Chloe, please. Ready?
Yes. There are lots of technology that I couldn't live without, but today I will talk about my smartphone. There are several reasons why I couldn't live without my smartphone. I got my first first smartphone during the first year of my college, because that is when my parents allowed me to start using a mobile. Firstly, I enter on the social media, and I used to spend a lot of time texting with my friend and family. So important to have a good bonding with our friend and relative. So I used to talk to them for a long time, around 2 or 3 years since I've been using the mobile ticket for me to live without it. Secondly, with my phone, I can do a lot. Example, take a photo, create a video clip. It's very helpful for my studying, because I work in the hospitality, so I need a photo for the food and a video clip how I can do that recipe. So with the phone, so I'll be very flexible for me to get easy to create the video clip. And finally, in my smartphone, when I bring the smartphone, I'm not worried about to carry a wallet, because in my smartphone have the insurance card, my credit card, everything in my phone. So I'm not worried about forget something like paper, privacy. When I want to go out. Yes.
Okay, that was awesome. That was really good. You went straight for the structure. That was fantastic. So Khan Chloe has done this work before, so she has remembered. The same with Dizzy. They have remembered the structure, because we teach this structure all the time because it's very effective. Okay, so you did that straight away. There was one little thing there, Khan Chloe, when you were talking about the flexibility,
yes,
of taking video clips of the
smartphone.
On the smartphone at work. So yeah, the same as what I said to Emilio, I think you could use the word convenient.
Convenient, yeah.
Would be better. It is convenient at work.
Yeah, yeah, convenient.
To take videos of the recipes.
Yep.
Yeah.
Thanks, teacher, to Christina.
You're very welcome. Okay, who is next? I think the only person left is Alvin.
Yeah.
He's been sitting there quietly.
I don't know what I want to say.
That's all right. You just go for it. Just look at this.
Okay. I try. There are a lot of technology I can talk about, but today I want to talk about a mobile apps I'm using regenerate. I downloaded the app. It's a shop pack. I think it's a shop pack. Used since this year. So I can use it to buy food, drink, shopping, or book online booking, and buy the flight ticket, or book the Airbnb. Can do many things. Just use the mobile apps, so I will always use it to book, because the reason is they give me the feedback is close 2%, the money come back to my account, nearly close 2%. So I really like use the apps. Normally I don't use any apps. I don't like use apps, and I will use a cash or just go to the shop and buy something. But I will use this one. I want to talk about the benefit about this apps. I think you can go to try to use it, because they got a lot of benefit you can use. You can use for convenience shop, for shopping, for buy something. Even you buy online, you busy, you can buy something at home. At least you can get feedback close nearly 2%. So the last I want to say, share this ShopBack X apps for you. I think this one is a technology I will using now, and I can't live without it now at this moment. Thank you.
Good. That was a nice conclusion, Alvin. That was very good. That was really good.
I don't know what to say.
Because... No, that was good. It was actually really interesting. I'm like thinking, oh, this sounds all right. Where can I get this? Can you explain to me what you mean by feedback?
Feedback is the money come back to my account. I don't know how to say it. I think they got some rebate, the money to account. Maybe
rebate. Is that what it is, Chloe and Mode? Is that how it works? You get a rebate?
Yeah, rebate.
I think it's a rebate.
Yeah. So you can use that word rebate. That makes perfect sense.
Okay, rebate.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So I use the apps because I get a rebate, a cash rebate.
A cash rebate, yeah.
Yeah. Or credit rebate, I guess. There is no cash. Yeah. Okay, that was good. That was very good. You did well. Congratulations.
Thank you.
All right, everyone. I just want to say that was actually really interesting to listen to everyone talking. I learned a lot about the way you use technology. So that was very interesting what you use it for. And yeah, thanks for that. That was awesome. All right, let's have a break, guys. And we'll come back in a few minutes.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, teacher.
No worries. We'll be right back.
shadow on the street now. I hear you push through the rusty gate. Click of your heels on the concrete. Waiting for a knock coming way too late. It seems an age since I've seen ya. Countdown as the weeks trickle into day. So you come in and put your bags down. I know there's something in the air. How can I do this to you right now? If you're over there when I need you here.
Hey everybody, we're back. We're going to do some reading comprehension. Dizzy, can you tell everyone what comprehension means? Do you understand?
Sorry, Dizzy, I didn't hear because of my sermon.
Do you know what the word comprehension means?
Oh, sorry, I forget it now. Sorry.
That's okay. All right, so let's do a quick vocabulary practice. So I want everybody to look up the word comprehension. Let me just put it in the Zoom chat. So I want meaning. Three synonyms in a sentence. Okay. So, Rayland.
Yes, teacher.
You can, let me just find a dictionary. I'll send you a link. Okay, so you can open this.
Where is
and
that?
You can look up the word. It's in the Zoom chat. I sent you Zoom a dictionary chat. Link.
Oh, where is that?
Okay, so I've sent you a dictionary and a thesaurus. The dictionary is where you find the meaning of the word comprehension, and a thesaurus is where you find the synonyms. A synonym is a word, is a different word that has the same meaning. So you need to find three new words that have the same meaning as comprehension. So for both of these links, you can just type the word into the search bar, okay?
Okay.
All right, so you guys put all that in chat.
Yes, Mimis?
Yes.
That is what for what?
This a scintilla, was it?
Sorry, sorry, Bayou. Can you repeat your question, please?
What's the meaning from? Any word?
No, the meaning of comprehension. Can you see the chat box?
Yes.
Yeah, so I want you to look up comprehension.
Okay.
Sorry, Rayland, did you have a question?
It's all right.
You're okay?
Yeah.
We have to find three different words that is mean comprehension, too.
Correct. So three synonyms, Dizzy. So that's where you use the thesaurus. Yep, good, Dizzy. All right, do number three. That's good, Chloe. Lie. Is that true?
I don't know. She's a naughty girl. Sometimes she did things not through her head.
She doesn't think before she acts. Is that what you mean?
Yeah.
That's funny. How old is your sister?
Only 29 this year.
29? Yeah, okay. Yeah.
But she's just like my baby sister, like age in baby
sister. So is she older or younger than you?
Younger.
Okay, so she is your baby sister, but she definitely acts like it too, right?
Yeah. But that's the way she like being cute.
Oh no. Yeah. And I think that can be frustrating for people like you, right?
No, it's okay. Yeah.
You think it's cute?
Yeah, sometimes. Just sometimes.
Does she live in Taiwan still?
Yeah. Because my older sister also in Melbourne. So it's only my younger sister and my mom in Taiwan now.
Oh, okay.
She has to like take care of my mom, but she always say, oh, I'm busy at work and blah, blah, blah. I don't have time to like accompany my mom.
Oh, really?
Yeah, but I talk to her a lot. So she's getting better of like being a good kid.
She will. She'll get better. Yeah. She's at the age now where she'll grow up soon.
Yeah, true.
Yeah, and she probably will start missing your mum more.
Like me.
Yeah. Okay, Steffi, good, perfect job. Thank you. Congratulations. Okay, Raylan, you can look at the other examples. That are in the chat box if you are finding it hard to know exactly what to do.
Okay. What's the chat box?
Mode, you've used comprehension in the wrong way in your sentence.
All right. Okay. I will.
Yeah. It doesn't make sense that way. It would be driving the vehicle without a permit would lead to a court conviction.
Oh.
Not a court comprehension. It's a different thing. And same with you, Khan Chloe.
Yeah.
You've written my friend's comprehension with her children. What? The sentence is not finished. You need to explain what the comprehension is.
All right.
Oh, where's the text box?
Yep, good, Emilio. Very good. Nice. Very sweet. Is that true?
Yeah, is that true?
I think with that sentence, though, Emilio, just to finish it off better, you could say, I appreciate the comprehension that my wife has towards other people's problems.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
How are you going with your sentence, Dizzy?
It's like a thing because I have two little babies here fighting for one cola.
Oh, babies.
They're not babies, but I call them babies because sometimes they're doing like babies.
They act like babies.
He's laughing.
Maybe he should do your work for you.
He said that before, teacher, when he was sitting here with me, he said, Mommy, I can help you if you need help.
I can help you. Okay, yeah, that's good, Emilio. So just when you write towards other people, you need to put an apostrophe and an S. So it needs to be other people's
problems. Problem, apostrophe, S. Okay.
Yeah, people, apostrophe, S. So just like I would say Emilio's car, that is your car. So this is other people's problems. It's their problems. So when we own something, we use apostrophe, S.
Okay.
Ms. Sterling, I think you sent me the private.
Yeah.
Bayou. okay, Mode, let's see. The way he has comprehension in solving the puzzles is very impressive. So I would say in that case, Mode, I would say he has impressive comprehension in solving puzzles. Because comprehension is all about understanding. So you've used you've used it as it is a verb. I have comprehension, but you need to say more that he understands how to solve the puzzle. So he has impressive comprehension skills when he solves puzzles. Does that make sense, Mo? Not really.
I'm not sure. The way he has impressive comprehension skills.
He has good impressive comprehension skills when he solves puzzles.
He solves. Yes. Past tense, is it?
Yeah.
Solve puzzle.
How you going, Alvin? Okay, the comprehension my children have because I take good care of them. No, that's not the way it's used, Dizzy. You would say my children has... You could say, so your children have grown up in Australia, yeah?
Yes.
Yeah, so what you could say is my children have good comprehension of English. I know what you're trying to say. You've taught them comprehension. You've taught them to understand things, but you haven't used it in the right way in that sentence.
Okay, just think.
Okay, so... Mo, you just need to write when he solved the puzzle. Sorry.
Yeah.
When he solved the puzzle. Bayou, you've sent me a message. That's nice.
Puzzle got S, isn't it?
Oh, you can, if you say puzzles, that's more than one. So you can say when he solved puzzles. Or you need to say when he solved a puzzle. One or the other. Bayou, that's good. So just with your sentence, you need to say many people, not peoples.
Ah, yeah. People. I just
don't have good comprehension about, and you would say driving rules.
Oh, and then I say driving rules.
Oh, about the rules of driving. Yeah, so the sentence should be many people don't have good comprehension.
Yep.
About
driving on the roads. I like that. Oh.
No, we want to use rules. So let's say many people don't have good comprehension about road rules.
Road rules.
Road rules. Is that it? Yes. So when I learned to drive, I had to learn the road rules. That's how I'm using it. Do you want me to say it again, Bayou?
Yes, please.
Okay. Many people don't have good comprehension about road rules.
Oh, goodness. Thank you.
No worries, Bayou. Thank you. Comprehension means understanding completely with situations, sense, knowledge, intelligence. When you lack comprehension, good. Okay, they're very nice sentences, Alvin. I can see you've done a little bit of Googling there. That last sentence.
always Google.
I know, I can see.
If no that... Google, I die.
Oh, no, 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 don't say that.
Okay, just kidding.
So you could say at the bottom, so this last sentence we need to change a little bit. My colleagues don't... Okay, so just like Bayou sent then, you would say, my colleagues don't have good comprehension of work skills, okay, or something like that, or of work
okay
procedures. Do you want me to say that again, Alvin?
Yeah, please.
Okay, so look at Bayou's sentence, and I will say, my colleagues don't have good comprehension
okay
about work procedures.
Oh, procedures. All right.
Okay. All right, how are you going, Rayland?
Not yet.
Okay, not
I'm
yet.
I'm loading. Sorry, I'm loading.
Are you you're loading?
Yeah.
Oh no. All right. I'll put it up on the page so that you can see what we need to do. If you're loading, it's too hard.
Yeah.
All right. So I'm still waiting for Khan, Chloe, and Alvin. All right. Hopefully, I can copy this. Oh. Yes. Okay, Rayland, if you just look at the screen.
Yeah.
We use this technique or this strategy to try to learn new vocabulary. So we're just talking about the word comprehension. Oh,
okay.
Let me just make that. So this is the word we looked up in our dictionary.
Yes.
And this is what the meaning is. So everyone else, actually, you should look at this sentence because this is the correct way. The meaning of comprehension is to understand the nature or meaning of something.
Okay.
Rather than just comprehension and then copy in the dictionary. So these words here, Rayland.
Yes.
These are the synonyms. Okay, so I could change the sentences that the other guys have been putting into Zoom, and I could use these words instead of comprehension. It is hard to discern the road rules. It is hard to grasp the work procedures. It is hard to fathom what my children know about life. So really, comprehension is all about understanding. So this is why I wrote this sentence here, guys. When I take the IELTS exam, the reading section will have comprehension questions. Okay, we'll fix your sentence in a second, Khan, Chloe. So when I go back to our reading page, there it is there. So when we do our reading in IELTS, so you guys have this as well in your Moodle, so you can look at this too if you need. So we read the passage. And then these questions are comprehension questions. So they're testing you on how well you understood the reading passage. All right, so we've only got a very short amount of time. So when we finish, guys, give this a go. So read this. If you've got time, put a timer on your phone for 20 minutes. Read this. Read this article. It goes all the way down with my very slow mouse. Oh, keep going. Read the article and then try the questions. So just try questions 1 to 6. So this is not homework. This is for you to try to practice comprehension. It's very important. You can learn the words in English, but that doesn't mean you understand them. So that's why we do the vocabulary exercise all the time. So you might learn the word, you might learn how to spell it, but we need you to understand the word. So when it comes to taking your reading test or even just reading English, you'll be able to answer the questions properly because you understand. Okay, so I just want to quickly go back to our core principles. Do some more work on our reading tomorrow.
Yeah, but I want to ask about the speaking exam you added before on the Red 5.
Mm-hmm.
We have to do it today, or we can have, you can do that tomorrow too.
So do you mean the homework for week one?
Yeah, the speaking part, yeah, out of Red 5.
Okay, so we talked about this yesterday, actually, Dizzy. So good question.
I can't connect it yesterday.
No, that's okay. I'm just saying, like, we went through this, so like, I'm not saying you're in trouble. I'm just saying we went through this so that everyone can understand how to do the homework going forward. So let me just share this. So you can see, Dizzy. So this is in your Moodle. I'll do that after class to make sure it's in there. So you go to Red 5. You go to weekly online assignments. So this is what you need to do by the end of the week. So try to get it done by Thursday.
Week one or all the weeks? Week two or three?
No, just week one. So this is week one now. So can you see the beginning module? See, there's no more modules. We've got 5 weeks in each intake. That's what we call it, an intake. This is week one.
Yeah, and now it's called weekly.
This one down here.
Okay, weekly online assignments. Okay, thank you.
Yeah, no worries. So by the end of this week, do week one, okay?
Miss Darling, I got a question, please.
Yes.
Because I clicked all the weeks yesterday, but it all say it overdue.
Yeah, I noticed that this morning as well when I was looking at it. I don't think the actual thing is there. I need to ask Miss May. So you remember when you did your homework last week, you just went straight to it and it opened up the question? I don't think you have this option here, do you?
Yeah.
So when I go to the grade, this is just one person. I think, hang on. Oh no, there it is.
It said it's overdue, but I still can add a submission.
Yeah, that's when, so this material may have been in Moodle maybe last year. So the system just takes the time that it was put in and it carries it over. Does that make sense?
Yeah. And yeah. Also the week two, it says it's listening, all listening, but I click in, it's like email to write or just word later to write. It's not like listening. Is that correct or? I got confused.
There's nothing to listen to, is there?
Yeah. Also, the second one is also not the same in the title.
Yeah. I think what she's done is she's copied this here and she's put it in the wrong heading.
Title. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
So this is your assignment because there's nothing to listen to, right?
Yeah.
So I think when you just click on grade, it's a bit different. So there's Raylan, for example. And that's not working. I'll double check on all of this, okay?
Yep.
Because that looks like there's listening there. All right, no worries. Maybe they're finishing it up. So you don't need to worry about that until the end of the week. I mean, you can do it all, you know, week two if you need to, for example. Right. This is not like the test will be on that day. We want you to finish it by the end of the week, and that's the plan. But if you don't, just tell us and then we'll know where you're up to with homework.
It's like homework, teacher, yeah?
It's like what, sorry?
Dizzy? It's like homework. It's not test. You have to do it on
the test. Yeah, correct. So assignments, homework, same thing.
So assignments. This one, like online assignments.
Who's speaking? Is that Raylan?
This one, teacher, weekly online assignments.
Correct. Yep.
So... Which this one, the week one?
Yep. So right now, Roland, can you see week one, week two, week three, week four?
Yeah. Yep.
So if you go to week five, that's our very last week. So we have 5 weeks in our program. Yeah, and then in 5 weeks, we start again to week one.
Okay.
All right. So right now we're in week two, which is what we're doing, technology. Week two, media.
Week two.
So when you go to your weekly online assignments, you've got week one, week two, week three, week four.
Teacher, sorry for interrupting. Can I go? Because I have to give something to eat to my voice before they sleep.
Yep, no worries. We're finished now anyway. Yeah.
Thank you so much. Have a good night.
Thanks, Dizzy. You too. See you later, Dizzy.
Bye. Good night, everyone.
Okay, I'll check with Miss May as to why these don't look like they should. Maybe she's still writing them. but let's check back in on that tomorrow. And, we'll continue our reading comprehension tomorrow. So remember what reading means. what comprehension means when you do your reading. All right, guys. Great class again. I will see you all tomorrow, okay?
Okay, we'll see you tomorrow, teacher. Thank you so much.
Have a good day. A good night.
Good night, everyone.
Bye, Alvin, Emilio, Chloe.
Bye, teacher.
See you. Thank you.
See you.
Bye, everyone.